I don't need to tell you that the muscles are the only thing that allows you to move, but I will tell you how they do it. The basic function of the muscle is to contract. First, there are three types of muscles. But let's talk about skeletal. You won't impress the ladies with your cardiac muscle, am I right? Skeletal muscles, as their name suggests, are the ones that make your bones move. They come in pairs, one muscle to move the bone in one direction and another to move it back the other way. So, how exactly do muscles do what they do? A muscle is a bundle of many cells, called fibers, like strands of hair. A muscle fiber contains many myofibrils. Those are muscle proteins that allow muscle cell to contract. Those proteins do the actual work of the muscle, and the way they do this is pretty cool. In the middle, we have a protein called myosin. At the molecular level, myosin molecules are arranged in a cylinder and have these heads. The other one is protein called actin and looks like two strands of pearls twisted around each other. During contraction, the myosin grabs onto the actin and pulls it past it, making the sarcomere shorter. In a muscle fiber, the signal for contraction is synchronized over the entire fiber so that all of the myofibrils that make up the sarcomere shorten simultaneously. If you do the pull-ups, the chances are you are gonna get calluses on your hands. The skin on the palm of your hands will thicken and harden to form a layer of armor to protect your hands from tears and blisters. That's exactly what happens with your muscle when you work out. As you stress your muscle, it develops very small, microscopic tears in them, and the body responds by recruiting amino acids, which are the building blocks of protein, to come and repair your muscle. However, the body recognizes that this muscle will be subject to this type of damage and rebuilds muscle bigger and stronger to adapt to this new stimuli. In the end, you end up with more of these myofibrils inside your muscle fibers, and you get stronger. This is called the myofibrillar hypertrophy, which means you develop more myofibrils, but there is another one, called sarcoplasmic hypertrophy, that increases volume of the non-contractile muscle cell fluid, called sarcoplasm. Although the cross-section area of the muscle increases, the density of muscle fibers decreases, and there is no increase in muscular strength. Now my friend over at Project Better Self will tell you how exercise affects the brain. Go check his video and don't forget to subscribe.